Hello, everyone. You are now tuned in to the La Frontera Times Icebreaker. As we reflect on July 29th, SB 1070, and the immigrant rights movement in general, let's get one thing perfectly clear. Despite the fervor, prayer, and blind gratitude given to Judge Susan Bolton, the partial injunction of SB 1070 legislation is by no means a victory, meaning the struggle has only begun. SB 1070 has already decimated the number of day laborers on Arizona streets able to find work to feed their families and themselves. Members of the Puente movement are among the voices in this human rights struggle that have been critical towards this act that has been falsely identified as a concession. Their July 28th press release read, "A split decision only serves to split our communities. There is no partial solution to denials of our humanity. There is no partial solution to hatred. If this is a step, it is another step toward increased encroachments on the human rights of the people of Arizona and a dangerous precedent for the country." Pablo Alvarado of the National Day Laborer Organizing Network added, "The partial and temporary blocking of a law that should have never existed is welcome, but in no way a victory. The conditions that created SB 1070 remain and are only worsened by the decision today." In fact, Senator Russell Pierce, the actual author of SB 1070, downplayed Susan Bolton's July 28th ruling by saying that it was only temporary anyway. Additionally, the part of the bill that requires agencies to enforce federal immigration law to the fullest extent remains intact. So while devoted protesters engaged in civil disobedience on July 29th, Governor Jan Brewer celebrated SB 1070's partial implementation by applying to the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals for an expedited hearing on the law so that its full racist force could be enacted. Although the expedited appeal was denied, the case will be heard the first week of November, and Governor Brewer and her racist minions across the United States will no doubt use the upcoming legal battle to their political advantage as elections approach. So, we can all expect more statisticless platforms of securing America's borders, platforms about enforcing laws against drug mules, platforms about enforcing states' rights, and platforms about enforcing laws that are already on the books. So expect Jan Brewer to take this all the way to the U.S. Supreme Court if need be. Armed with a fund that has already raised $1.6 million to get SB 1070 passed in its entirety, and that raised $75,000 alone the day Susan Bolton issued her partial injunction, Brewer will win unless an organized mass movement stops her. Now in boycott news. In addition to Budweiser, Hensley Beverage Company, Anheuser-Busch, the Arizona Diamondbacks, Jimmy John's Gourmet Sandwiches, Tostitos Frito-Lay, and the state of Arizona in general, our nationwide boycott has a new target. Its name? Target. Target has donated $150,000 to Minnesota Forward, a pro-corporation group that directly supports Tom Emmer. Who is Tom Emmer? Tom Emmer is a Republican candidate for governor in Minnesota this November. Target claims the donation to his campaign was based on Emmer's tax and jobs platform. But a closer look at his politics shows that he is a staunch supporter of SB 1070 and is running on an anti-immigrant platform. Aside from stating that SB 1070 was a wonderful start, during a live show on Minnesota Public Radio, Tom Emmer has sponsored bills to make English the official state language, require citizenship for college financial aid, to eliminate health coverage for labor and delivery for undocumented pregnant non-citizens, and other legislation targeting immigrant workers. On his own campaign website, he objected to Susan Bolton's partial and temporary injunction to SB 1070 by stating that every state has the constitutional authority, even the obligation, to protect its citizens from any threat to the safety of their person or their property. In other words, protect its citizens from brown folk. Oh, but it gets worse, people. Quote, "The massive wave of illegal immigration has created a culture of violence, exploitation, human trafficking, and crime." Unquote. We at La Frontera Times encourage our readers to boycott Target and all those who have financially forwarded the cause of racists and their anti-human rights legislation. MoveOn.org is currently circulating a petition that has so far garnered over 260,000 signatures of people who have promised to boycott Target until they commit to stop trying to buy elections. Thank you for tuning in, everyone. Stay awake for the next La Frontera Times icebreaker at www.lafronteratimes.com.